Hi everyone, this is H. Atiq Ahmad. I welcome all of you to my channel Engineering Drive. Let us start a series of videos on one important subject of computer science, that is data structures. So in this today's introduction video about this subject, let us have a glimpse of idea about what is a data structure and why our computer uses these data structures. Okay, before going to that, let us have a basic concept of why we are going to have an idea on this data structure subject. Why it is very important and how it plays a vital role in computer science. For example, let us take our computer. What we will do on a computer? A computer, first of all, takes the input from the user. Computer takes the input from the user. Let us say this is our computer. Takes the input. It will process the input. And then what our computer will do finally? It will produce the output. So a computer is an electronic machine which accepts the input, processes the input, and produces the output. Okay. Who will provide the input to the computer? Users will provide the input. So here, user. And who will see the output? Here also, user will see the output. So here also user, and right side also user. But who will do the ultimate processing inside our computer itself? Now, the question that comes in our mind is, when a computer takes the input, of course it will process the input. Whether always it will give the output to the user? No, it is not mandatory. Sometimes, yes, it will give the output to the user, and many times that instead of giving the output, the data will be stored in memory. Okay. Sometimes directly the output will be given to the user, or if the user don't want to see the output, then what happens? Instead of giving the output to the user, the data will be stored in memory. Now the question that comes in our mind is, which language our computer understands? Our computer understands only one language, that is binary language, or we can simply call it as machine language. You know how many digits are used in machine language? Yes, you are right. Only two digits, zeros and ones. So 0 0 1 0, this is an example of machine language. A computer takes some input which is in user defined language. It will convert that into binary. It will perform processing. Again, that binary data will be converted in user understandable format in the form of output, or that binary data will be stored itself in memory. Now, in order to store data, in order to store that output, in order to store the data inside computer, computer will make use of different methods. Data doesn't mean that directly there will be some racks. Suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here I am having 6 bits. How these 6 bits are stored in computer? So there is no fixed method like this. I will be showing you. 0 1 0 0 1 and last one 0. Whether computer follows only one method? No, computer uses different of types of methods in order to store this data in memory. We call those different types of methods as data structures. Hopefully you got clear. Now a computer has many things that it can provide user in the form of output. Many times our computer does not produce output directly to the user. Instead of that, there are many cases where user is not interested in output. User is interested to store the data in memory. So computer not only stores the data in memory in only one format. There are several methods our computer will make use of. All those methods are nothing but we call them as data structures. So what are those methods? We are going to see in this introduction video. So let me give you some idea on this one. So hopefully you got clear about this picture. that what our computer is doing, it will be sure. Here I will be discussing on what types of methods our computer makes use to store that output or to store the user related data in memory. We call those methods as data structures. Okay, so data, in simple words, what is data structure? Means it is a method of accessing the data or retrieving the data in a computer. Computer makes use of some methods where the data will be stored in memory, or similarly, whenever a computer wants, it can retrieve the data from the memory. We can simply call them as data structures. Or in more simple words, a data structure is nothing but a way of organizing the data. Way of organizing. Organizing in the sense insertion, deletion. Okay. Now see here. So in our computer, there are two types of data structures supported. There are totally two categories of data structures supported by our computer. One is known as linear data structures. Another one is known as non-linear data structures. There are two categories of data structures, two categories of methods supported by our computer to organize the data in memory. One is linear data structures, another one is non-linear data structures. So what is linear data structures and what are the methods that comes under this? What is non-linear data structure and what are the methods comes under this? Let us have an idea. While coming to linear data structures, I think we have listened already these names. You know, if you have an idea of C programming language, one example of linear data structure is arrays. Then we are having one more example, stacks, queues, and linked lists. So these are very, very important. We can simply call them as heart of the data structures. Our computer makes use of arrays, stacks, queues, and linked lists to store the data in different formats. We call those set of formats as linear data structures. Whereas our computer makes use of another technique, another set of data structures where the data will be stored. Those are nothing but trees and graphs. My next videos, I will be preparing separate set of videos for linear data structures and a separate set of videos for non-linear data structures. Okay. What is the main difference are between linear and non-linear data structures? One of the important and main difference between linear and non-linear data structures is a linear data structure stores the data in a proper order. There will be some order. There will be some sequential order where the data will be stored in linear. Whereas non-linear data structure, you can see that the data will be stored in hierarchical format or in a level format, in a level format, simple words. Okay. And how linear data structure and non-linear data structure differs, that we are going to see in our upcoming videos. Okay. So with the introduction of this data structure concept, let me close this today's session. And in my next session of data structures videos, I will be starting with the first linear data structure, that is arrays. So what is arrays? How the data will be stored in arrays? And how we can access the data from the arrays. So these are the set of things that we'll be discussing in our next stream of video in our concept data structures. Okay. So with this, I will close my today's session. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Take care. Allah Hafiz.